Hello, we're almost finished with week 5. To help you, we will summarize this week's content. At the beginning of week 5, we wanted to determine the slope of the roller coaster track and the speed of the cart. To do so, we started by defining the derivative. The setting was as follows. Suppose a function f is given. If you move from point A on the horizontal axis to a plus delta x, the function value changes. The quotient of the vertical change and the horizontal change is called the difference quotient. It can be interpreted as the slope of the green line. Now, take delta x to 0. If the limit of the difference quotient exists, it's called the derivative of f at a. It is denoted by f prime of a or df over dx of a. The green line approaches a limiting position. This is the tangent line to the graph at point P. To determine the derivatives of more complicated functions, we first take a look at the derivatives of the standard functions. You should remember the derivatives of power functions, exponential functions, and the logarithm. We also found the derivatives of sine of x and cosine of x. The derivative of sine of x equals plus cosine of x, and the derivative of cosine of x equals minus sine of x. And in the exercises, we found that the derivative of the tangent of x equals 1 divided by the cosine of x squared. So far are standard derivatives. Now let's look at the rules to calculate the derivatives of combinations of standard functions. The derivative of a constant times a function equals the constant times the derivative of the function. The derivative of f plus g equals the derivative of f plus the derivative of g. This is the sum rule for differentiation. We also know the product rule. This rule states that the derivative of fx times gx equals f prime of x times gx plus g prime x times fx. Furthermore, the chain rule tells us that f of gx equals the derivative of f at value gx times the derivative of g at value x. Finally, the derivative of f divided by g can be calculated using the quotient rule, but remember that you can also derive it by using a combination of the chain rule and the product rule. So these were all of our rules. You should note that derivatives do not always exist. This might happen for several reasons. Some examples of instances where a function f is not differentiable at a occur when f is not continuous at a, the graph of f has a kink at a, or the graph of f has a vertical tangent line at a. There are even more exotic examples, but you will not encounter those often. Finally, we looked at how to determine local extrema of a function. The most important result is the following. If a function f attains a local maximum or minimum at x is a, then either the derivative of f in a equals 0, f is not differentiable at x equals a, or the point a is a boundary point of the domain of f. The point where the derivative of f equals 0 are called critical points. Points where the derivative does not exist are called singular points. And if a point at the boundary of the domain, we call it boundary point. To find the maximum or minimum of f, you must check all three points. This was all the theory about differentiation. If something from this summary is not completely clear to you, you can go back to the video explaining that part. Good luck with this week's exercises.